Another important instrument of capital market is the euro issues. This is also a source of finance or capital for companies. They can raise money from outside the home country in the case of these instruments. That is, in the case of the euro issues or euro instruments, the home country can raise or home companies can raise funds from foreign capital. That is, Indian companies can raise capital from the other countries of the world through the issue of shares and through the issue of these kinds of instruments. And the most commonly used instruments that comes under the euro issues are American Depositary Receipts, ADR, and Global Depositary Receipts, GDR, and Foreign Currency Convertible Bonds, FCCB. These are the important euro instruments that are available or most commonly used as euro issue instruments. First one, the Global Depositary Receipts. Global Depositary Receipts, the company can issue equity shares. They can keep them in custody of domestic custodian. Whereas there will be an overseas depository bank. This bank issues fresh securities in nature of GDR in the foreign market, the respective companies. That means domestic market is the custodian of equity shares of or the issue of equity shares, and there will be a depository bank in foreign countries. From there, it will be issued. Procedure of GDR. The issues will be under the guidance of the government of India. Or this is a process of issuing securities in a foreign country by a foreign depository bank, which are authorized by the issuing company in the domestic country. That is, these are issued by a home country, company in a home country, and these are issued in foreign countries by a foreign depository bank. That is, through these foreign depository banks, these are issued in the foreign country, and the issue of these bonds, issue of these shares happens in the home country. That is, GDR of Indian company are issued by the Indian company, and these are sold out, or these equity shares are issued in foreign country, for example in USA, by the foreign depository that is existing in the USA. That is the case of GDR, and GDR are usually listed in exchanges in Europe. Every issues have to be listed in an exchange, and in the case of GDR, these are listed in the European exchanges. The second one is the ADR or American Depositary Receipt. This is same as GDR, but this will be listed and traded on New York Stock Exchange. In the case of GDR, that will be listed and issued through the European exchange, whereas this will be American Depositary Receipts. And the procedures are the same, but it will be listed in the New York Stock Exchange. The third instrument is Foreign Currency Convertible Bonds, FCCBs. It is very similar to the bond, and it can be converted into equity stock at a pre-agreed price. These are issued by the Indian companies outside the home country. Foreign currency enjoy high preferences, and these are issued as per the guidelines of the government of India. That means these are the bonds in nature, and it can be converted into equity stock at a future agreed price. They are issued by the Indian companies outside the home country in foreign currency and guided by the rules and regulations of government of India. The features of ADR and GDR. One of the important feature of euro issue is that companies can offload the share to an international depository. There will be a foreign depository bank, and we can offload our equities or shares into that depository, but these shareholders doesn't have the voting right. Another important feature is that in the case of the GDR and ADR, there won't be voting right. And second feature is that ADR and GDR can be listed and traded at the global stock market. They can be listed and traded at the global stock market. Third one, receipts of shares issued in US is known as ADR, and in other parts of the country it is the GDR. Most of the reputed Indian companies are enjoying listing at the global stock market through the ADR routes, and that this provides an opportunity for Indian companies to attain the global market through the ADR. And Indian companies can test the competitiveness and global accessibility. The Infosys company is the first Indian company that is listed in Nasdaq 1999. What are the advantages of Euro issues? This first advantage is that these are a cheap source of fund, foreign currency. That is, these are the best and the cheap method of attaining foreign currency, and this can be used as a source of finance by the companies. Second one, in the case of funding by way of equity, debt equity ratio, debt service coverage ratio, etc. won't be an issue in the case of Euro issues. Third one, it provides a large market and international access to funds. Fourth one, international exposure and enhances the liquidity of the money also, or liquidity position also. These are some of the important advantages of the Euro issues, that is cheap source of fund. There won't be the problems with respect to the equity shares, equity ratios, debt service charges, etc. It provides large market, international access to funds, international exposure to companies, and it enhances the liquidity. The disadvantages of the Euro issues. First important disadvantage of the Euro issue is that it may create a problem of currency exchange risk. Second one, all companies cannot avail funds through the issue market, through the Euro issue market or Euro issues. All the companies cannot risk capital through Euro issues. The companies needs the guidelines and the directions from the Reserve Bank of India. This is some of the important limitations of the Euro issues.